People have allergies to foods like dairy, egg, and soy, which can make it tough to eat well. Plus, some vegetarians are just tired of soy. That's why some are turning to an unlikely source of protein, like peas and rice. Food coach Lori Corbin shows us some creative ways to get these veggie proteins into your diet.
We like pea protein because of the fact that it's allergen friendly. And really at the end, when you have so many allergies, casein allergies and soy allergies and milk allergies, peas is just very, very neutral.
Another high quality allergen free option, rice protein.
And that complete protein source was equal to that of a whey protein isolate. So it is a complete protein source, provides all the necessary nutrition in the right amounts, and the body can absorb it equally throughout the day.
Offering a high quality source of protein to add to soups, sauces, pasta, oatmeal, and more. Lori Corbin, ABC 7.
Women have dealt with the awful symptoms for years, but don't learn they have polycystic ovarian syndrome until they try to have a family.
Well, this being PCOS Awareness Month, we wanted to introduce you to a woman who was diagnosed who thinks that she has mastered the syndrome and also lost the weight that it packed on.
Becky Miller is 110 pounds in her 5'2 frame, but that was not the case 5 years ago.
It took me a year to get an official diagnosis.
Becky had polycystic ovarian syndrome, but didn't know it. PCOS takes your carbs and spikes your insulin, which spikes your male hormones, which causes your ovaries to produce cysts, or follicles that contain no eggs. She has since eliminated sugar and hormone-laced dairy products.
So I am drinking just original almond milk.
She uses products that help regulate her body's hormone levels.
It's a really good protein shake for women who have PCOS.
She has dropped 20 to 30 pounds and is ovulating every month.
It is regular to the day, which has never, ever happened in my entire life, and that was just through food.
Now Becky dedicates her life to helping other women, hoping that she can get them to a diagnosis sooner.
Hi, I'm Dr. Janet Brill. I'm a nutritionist and author and spokesperson for the American Heart Association. I am here to dispel a few common myths about the new trends in plant-based diets. Myth: protein supplements are just for bodybuilders. Fact: the average adult needs 65 to 80 grams of protein per day, depending on their size, activity, age, and gender. In order to maintain muscle, a body needs to replenish that amount every day. Protein is considered the building block of the body. Many people don't get enough protein from whole foods, so supplements are a solution for them. Myth: protein powders are just for shakes. Fact: protein powder can be sprinkled or stirred into sweet and savory dishes morning, noon, and night, making any meal high in protein. For example, in the morning, you could stir chocolate rice protein into pancake mix or oatmeal. For lunch, you could put pea protein into salad dressing. And in the afternoon, you can mix plain rice protein into pasta sauce or baked goods. Myth: you can't build as much muscle on plant-based protein as you can on animal-based whey. Fact: a double-blind clinical trial published in 2013 in the Nutrition Journal shows the same benefits between plant-based rice protein and animal-based whey in building, strengthening, and repairing muscle. Additional research, due to be published in 2014, shows that leucine, the amino acid known to build muscle, is better absorbed from plant-based rice protein than animal-based whey. Myth: it takes the same amount of natural resources to provide humans with 1 gram of plant-based protein as compared to 1 gram of animal-based protein. Fact: it takes 13 pounds of grain and 2,400 plus gallons of water to produce 1 pound of meat. It takes 5 pounds of fish feed to produce 1 pound of fish. So instead of growing plants to feed the animals and then process and eat the animal, why not grow a plant and eat that? For more information, you can check out facebook.com/DrJanetHealth.
Hi, I'm Heather Ranson, and we're here at Deuce Gym with Maria Bertrand
and Jay Viola,
my buddy Walkerman.
Hi!
Do you know the difference between vegan and vegetarian?
Can you tell me a little bit about macrobiotics?
How many meals a day are you eating?
How old were you when you started?
I was born.
So my goal when I went vegan was to put on muscle and maintain.
And I thought to myself, how can I maintain this physique for the rest of my life?
It's not an easy transition to make. People
sometimes try to jump into it all at once, and they're like, this is crazy, how can you eat this way? Well, you can't.
Oh my God, like I couldn't live without it. I could never live without cheese.
Number one though, protein deficiencies.
Never, never count protein intake, ever.
Ooh, you're making me hungry.
They're just really high in iron.
Beans and rice, that makes a complete protein, you'll get all your amino acids.
Yeah, this is amazing.
Yeah, so lentils again are like gonna be
a staple.
Yeah, a good protein.
They have nachos.
There's like nothing on the menu that I wouldn't eat.
It's a good food and good company.
Yay. Give a little view of how beautiful this is. So this is right before.
Ta-da!
And here is our final result. It looks so
Yay!
Good.
There's a lot of stress out there. I like to talk to my patients sometimes what's called the triangle of health. And if any one of those sides falls, the whole triangle is going to collapse.
You don't want to eat too much salt or sodium, like animal products. You just want to have a balance.
Mentally, I felt even better than I do eating a healthy cooked food, being a diet.
We may have to amputate. We may have to take off part of your leg. There's two ways to kind of go with this. You either say, all right, I'm going in and I don't know what the outcome is, or I'm gonna take this head on.
And my mom actually passed away from cancer about 5 years ago, so just having that, I was like, this, so that was sort of a catalyst for me to make a change too, because I saw a disease in my family. I was like, I wanna be as healthy as I can for as long as I can, so.
This is basically the reason he decided to go vegan.
Pretty much, yeah. And these guys.
I think you can do it.
Definitely, go hard, do it. Let's see how you do.
I'm gonna do it.
Hold on, man. I'm standing up for the green today, dog. You know what I'm saying? Because green is on the flag. Yellow, red, you know what I'm saying? Don't talk about the green, dog. Meat eater.
Everybody talk about this vegan and all this and that.
Look, this is the trick right here. Just a little bit of coffee before you fuck some of these dudes up and that's it.
Do I feel like vegan athletes can compete at the higher level? Depends on the sport, really.
You know what I'm saying? No, hey, you ain't never seen no lion eat just vegetables. That's all I'ma say. Savage.
Rice protein all day.
Yeah, Irwin had to go get
all day.
Rice.
He didn't want it. I asked him. Back and forth.
He all vegan. He natural as hell. It ain't okay. That's a dog pit right there.
Nice
massage. So Riano, not bad. I need a haircut. Get Friday going, but still looking all right. I will.
I don't know. I'm from the country, so I believe in eating everything. You know what I mean?
Like meat's still working for me. For a couple guys I know it's not working, but I like and works for me like fine. So. I still want to try vegan, maybe in the future, not now.
Flip me with that shit, bro. What you got, vegan?
Nah, let's add the vegan. What's this? Got 100% whey protein isolate, vanilla flavor. Get you Nutra Bio, get you flexing. Check out the abs. Strong abs. We don't do no weakness.
He wants the rice, because you know they
see these guns?
You heard his percentage?
You gonna wait till you see my percentage. Look at that. That's all weight.
First of all,
wait,
the body type is different.
Wait, 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 wait.